After 2 years of tough restrictions, South Australians are finally free to dance and sing up a storm. Hundreds put on their dancing shoes overnight and headed to the city to hit the floor. It's been a long time coming for the hospitality sector, hamstrung by strict capacity limits throughout the pandemic.
As the clock struck 1 past midnight,
3, 2, 1,
South Australians hit the dance floor. For the first time in 2 years, all density limits at pubs and clubs have been removed. Singing and dancing is back. QR codes are no longer required on public transport or in educational facilities. And those who are COVID positive have to isolate for only 7 days instead of 10.
It's pretty exciting to be able to go out and do fun things again, but it is a little bit scary.
It'll be nice to actually dance again.
It's welcome news for the hospitality sector, who have been forced to operate at a reduced capacity or close their doors.
It's been difficult, but as restrictions are getting reduced, there's so much more positivity around. And
the last 2 years have been a really difficult time for anyone in the hospitality industry, nightclubs, pubs, restaurants, cafes.
And it's just in time for the March long weekend.
And we've got record numbers tonight for bookings, so we're over the moon.
I think it's great for the long weekend. What better way to celebrate?
Mask wearing and isolation requirements still remain in place, but will be reviewed at next week's COVID Ready Committee.
We'll see those over the coming weeks also reduced.
There was 2,374 new COVID cases reported in South Australia today. And while those figures are lower than daily case numbers this past week, traders say they still hold grave fears those harsh restrictions will make a return.
We've been here a couple of times before.
I don't have any confidence at all in the restrictions. They could change tomorrow.
But the Premier today reassured businesses that those restrictions are behind us.
I think business now has every confidence, because we have worked together well, that we can put the coronavirus behind us.
Katrina Musson for 10 News First.